Hello and welcome to another episode of the Commander Quest podcast. So, first of all, this week I am not doing magic news because there is no magic news. I will cover the one piece of magic news right now. There was a Zendikar Rising leak, Crawling Barrens. It's a land, you can tap it for colorless, and you can pay four to put two +1/+1 counters on Crawling Barrens. Then you may have it become a 0/0 elemental creature until end of turn. It's still a land. Not going to make a whole episode out of that. Maybe I should, but that seems kind of ridiculous. Alright, next is how to analyze Chief of the Foundry for your deck. So, Chief of the Foundry is 3 for an artifact creature construct. Other artifact creatures you control get +1/+1. So, at the end of the day, what you're doing is you are finding out how many artifact creatures you're likely to get that will be pumped. Well, all artifact creatures you get will be pumped, but you get the idea. So, this is very similar to other things like this, but first thing I want to point out is look at your commander. If you're playing something like Brea, you know that directly after you play Chief of the Foundry, you're going to play Brea. And then you're going to have 3 creatures from Brea and the 2 tokens that enter that are immediately going to get pumped. There are some commanders that it doesn't really even matter what cards you're running. You just know it's going to work. And you have enough support in your deck. You just kind of don't even need to analyze it. But, you know, we will go over this. Second thing I want to point out is this will work for any tribe. Sure, artifact is a super type, not a subtype, but that's kind of irrelevant. You can take this and you can apply it to any tribe at all. Honestly, I probably should have led with that because I just honestly realized that right now. But you can use this to analyze any tribe pump effect. So, let's get into it. So, the first thing you're going to do is you're going to go in your deck, right? You are going to open whatever type of spreadsheet program you like best. So, I personally use Google Sheets because I can use that on anything and all the, you know, computers and all this type of stuff I've used before. I've always had access to Google Sheets. That's not the point. But basically, what you're going to do is you're going to go in your deck, right? You are going to have basically a line for each CMC. So we'll do 1, we'll do 2, we'll do 3, and we'll just keep on going, right? So then once you have each of those lines, right, you are going to go in your deck. I'd recommend going up to 7 and just do 7 or more, so 7+, or 7 or more, however you want to format. Then what you're going to do is you're going to go in your deck, right? You're going to count the number of artifact creatures you control that are in your deck, right? You're not going to count your commander. We will deal with that later. Okay, so at each CMC, so the number of artifact creatures in my deck that are CMC1. I don't have an example deck, but we're just going to say 2. At CMC2, we're going to say there's 4. You know what, we'll go 5. CMC3, we're going to go 7. CMC4, we'll go 6. CMC5, we go 3. CMC6, we go 2. And 7+, we go 2 again. That seems pretty reasonable to me. Not necessarily 100% accurate, but if we add that up, that comes out to a total of, let's see, 27, which, oh wow, that is very high. Okay, so this is probably all should be cut in half, honestly. Not sure where I came up with these astronomically large numbers, but that's fine. We will fix that. Alright, so now that we have more reasonable, 14, right? What we're going to do, so if you think about it, Chief of the Foundry, right? Can I just drag this here? No, I can't. Okay, so if we think about it, Chief of the Foundry is 3 CMC. So if you cast it on turn 3, right, the cards that you would be able to cast before it came out that it would pump and you'd be able to attack with would be CMC 1 or 2. So at the exact point you cast it, right, there are 4 cards in your deck that it could pump. And I don't think I need to tell you, there's not a very high chance that out of 9 cards that you've drawn before you had Chief of the Foundry out, that you're going to get 1 of 4. I will show you with the hypergeometric distribution calculator, but it's not a really high chance. So population size 99, number of successes in population 4, sample size 9, and number of successes in sample is 1. So yeah, you have a 32% chance of that happening. It's possible, but it's not likely. So let's go to the next turn, right? So let's say we cast it on turn 4. Now, obviously, there's different ways we can do this, but if we cast it on turn 4, I'll detail the different ways we can do this in a second. What we can do is we can say, okay, so we're going to count everything from turn 3 and behind. So we can add 1 to that sample size, right? So we're up to 10, and our number of successes is 7. And suddenly we have a 53% chance. Not great, but significantly better. The way we could change this, by the way, is if we say we cast it on turn 3, right? But we could still count cards we drew on turn 4. We can just count cards we drew on turn 4, turn 2, and turn 1. Those CMCs. Basically, that just means I can go 11 and I can count 10 because I get all the CMCs. Generally, if there's a whole lot of overlap, that could be difficult, but generally it should be fine. All right, then that brings it up to a 71% chance. So it can be a very large difference if you play it that way. Then if we go up to turn 5, we're going to use that same method because I'd say A, it's a little bit more likely, and B, it's just a little bit more beneficial and works better. So we're going to go with sample size 12, and the number of successes is 12. So boom, now we have my golden number, my point where I'm willing to say you're probably going to get this. Almost all of the time is 80%, and we just reached 81%. So that's great. I mean, at this point, by turn 5, I can confidently say it'll pump one creature. But the issue is, this is a 3 CMC 2/3. If we have a 2/3 that pumps one other artifact creature by +1/+1, that's not great. So there's two things we can do. One is we can increase the numbers. We can say, oh, we're happier with a later turn. We have more artifacts in this. And two is we can change our commander. If we add Brea as our commander, we already know we are going to have three cards that are pumped. I touched the wrong colors, but we already know we're gonna have 3 cards that are pumped. So immediately, we are pumping 4 artifacts by +1/+1. And that's crazy. Now, obviously, there's a lot of different combinations. But I would say that probably about half or maybe even more of artifact commanders are going to have at least either or produce at least 1 artifact creature. So that will significantly help you. At the end of the day, I mean, if you think about it, is Chief of the Foundry really worth it if it only pumps 2 artifacts creatures? Is it really worth it? And in this scenario, I really wouldn't say it is. If you have that commander, if you have Brea, it's going to be worth it. But if you don't, is it really worth it? Because let's say your commander produces one artifact. You know, let's say your commander is an artifact creature, right? We can assume you're going to get at least one. But then from this experiment, even on turn 5, and you're not even getting the benefit until turn 6 because it has to attack, you're only pumping one additional creature. So is +2/+2 distributed among two creatures and a 2/3 really worth 3 mana? I don't really think it is. Now, this is up to you, and it totally depends on a whole lot of different scenarios, but I think these effects are overrated. It is very difficult to get it to a point where you really are happy with it. Most of these, I would say that point is 3. And to be happy with these cards, honestly, I generally want it to be, I will almost always get 3, and there's even a chance I'll get 4. Because that's what we need. We need the chance for it to go above and beyond and be amazing. And then if it doesn't, well, we know we're going to get at least good. And I don't think this delivers that. Now, as I said earlier, this will work with any tribe, and that could change for those. But do you really think, in your deck, obviously you're going to count and stuff, but before you do you really think you have more than 14 of that tribe? I don't think you do. In a very, very tribal deck, in a very creature-heavy deck, you might have 35 creatures. And obviously this is much more restrictive because it is artifact creatures, but I don't see you playing significantly more. I could see 20, maybe even 25, but there comes a point where you just can't really add too many more. And I would recommend you calculate this, and there are quite a lot, for example, zombies or elves, of tribes that have tons of playable cards. But if you're not in one of those tribes, and you're not running that many of them, reconsider. Is that pump effect really worth it? Thank you for listening, and I will see you next time.